G'day team, and welcome back to the House Spanish campaign. This is now episode 4. So I had a quick look around before I started recording. We're doing well. We're losing money, but that's because we are building, if you have forgotten, this bad boy. Our battleship, whose name I will not be pronouncing for the sake of our Spanish viewers and their ears. If you don't remember, we are trying to pick a fight with... That's something. Wrong campaign. Trying to pick a fight with Austria. We now have Sweden and Venezuela as our minor allies, who we are slowly selling all of our ships to. If you remember, we sold most of our light cruisers to Venezuela. We are also building more of those. These ones right here. Our research is looking good. No new hulls available, but more strengthening, more armor forging, no armor quality, gun layout, 8-inch casemate guns, turret mechanisms. Basically, we're catching up. If you remember, we had to turn off our research for almost a year last year to balance the budget, which we've now thankfully sorted out after a few bailouts from our very kind government and tanking of my naval prestige. At 52 ships, no battleships, but a lot of torpedo boats, we're doing very well. I might end up building more torpedo boats just because you can never really have enough. Yes. Alright, and with that, I think we'll end the turn. Lots of new technology from other countries and us. They're willing to pay 115%. Our shipyards are very empty, so I don't see why we wouldn't agree to this. China's trying to... they want the Philippines. Part of their 9-dash line, see? Do you think there's a late 1890s Xi Jinping somewhere in China? Just hungering over that 9-dash line? Maybe. Do we have Guam? I think we have Guam. Surely we have Guam. Might just not be on the map. Yeah, that's where we'd be basing that out of. Equatorial Guinea, nothing bad has ever happened there ever. Trust me, bro. Oh. I wonder if we should poke them again. Let's poke them again. See what they do. We don't really have the naval prestige to tank from that, because it lowers either way, from far as I'm aware. Yes. It's a good way to get me fired, is. But we'll build it up with events. Still building those light cruisers. Now building two of those. Shipyards, still very empty. I might just build more torpedo boats. Actually, you know what? I'm going to build 5 right now. Actually, let's see if we can build a new design. It's been a while, and I want more of these bad boys. Well, there's no new hull design. We can see if we can go up to the max displacement. We can. Max speed is 28. Standard. Don't have any upgrades down there. Look at the final capacity, it's so small. I think that's going to be our best bet. We do have Mark 2 3 inches, so we'll be sticking one up there. And now, for the reason you all came here today, torpedo launches. Our current ones have not enough. And that is how you build a torpedo boat. We'll go to 16-inch torps, because why not? We're not going to put them on fast, because I don't like how much that limits the range. Don't really gonna need shell damage. These don't matter. These don't matter. The gun does not matter. Alright. How expensive is this compared to our last one? It's over double the cost, but it's double the effectiveness. So, we'll just have to take that in stride. How many of these are we building? 3 million? We'll try and... six. Cool, we'll build seven. Why not? We got the money. How long do we have the money for? 10 months? I don't think these take 10 months to build. They don't. What do we want them, though? That's the question. That is the next question. May old crew be a good spot? Or Valencia. I don't think we really want this fleet's big enough. We don't really need more there. I think we should start building up a second fleet in Valencia. Once again, just for the idea of really sealing off this Mediterranean. If we could build some more light cruisers in there, that'd be even better. But we'll try and be a little bit careful of the money. I don't want the government bailing me out again. Not while I have negative 28 naval prestige. As it is, we're going to have to take any event that gives us naval prestige. Britain's trying to improve relations with us. That's good. I suppose we could put some ships off their coast, really annoy them, but I don't really want to do that. As research going, is there anything I really want? Cruiser design would be nice, but I believe... our current cruiser is getting a little bit on in the... You're right. Maybe... 5,000 ton heavy cruiser. Does it have a new design? It doesn't. Maybe we make a new cruiser as well. Not that we have the guns to really... No. You know, we're going to have to leave it. We'll do it eventually. But right now, we just don't have the... We can't build them. If we can't build them, there's no point in designing them. Because by the time we can build them, they're going to be 6-7 months out of date. Russia is revolted, which must be hard-coded into the game. Sweden would like another one. Are we really building one for you? They'll give us $14 million to do it. And a big chunk of money on delivery. I see, yes, we do it. Just because that money. That money's so good. And we, again, we're not using our shipyards. So if we're not using them, we might as well let someone else use them. I don't know who Sweden's preparing to fight, but they're buying a lot of these. And I mean, it'll benefit us if we ever have to fight Russia. Sweden having battleships only helps us. So we ended up with that cruiser. That's great. Torpedo tubes. Does that just give us two? That just makes them a bit lighter. That's fine. Mark II 9 inches, that's great for our cruisers in future. Submarine experiment, I'm not too worried about these. They're good when you get them, but until that point, I'm not too worried. Certainly not going to rush it. I rushed it in my China campaign. It didn't really help. Then again, I didn't have access. I really didn't have the States of Malacca. I didn't have something as good as Gibraltar. Sweden. Didn't we just build two of these for them? they're going to give us 2 million, 9 months. No, not right now. Not, I want a little bit of space left in here in case we go to war and I need to build anything. Expansion steam engines, that's great. really unprepared to fight submarines. I wonder if that's historical. I wonder how well they could predict submarines and know to build them. I know very early on, the Americans were mucking around with submarines. Oh, I cannot remember the man's name. I can't remember the man's name, but I know early 1901, they're mucking around with submarines. They sold some to the British. I believe they sold some to the Japanese. Very cool. They might actually say in the research. Nah, it doesn't. Sometimes they have a spiel. Yeah, I swear I will remember that man's name in an hour, and it's going to frustrate me until then. But yeah, it starts with a H, I swear. But yeah, he started designing submarines in the US very early on, selling them to the British. And that's basically, they weren't great functional submarines, but they let people build up submarine doctrines. Let people experience moving fleets around with them, how they could be threatened. Really interesting. Definitely, I know Wikipedia isn't the best, but if you can give it a read, really, really fascinating stuff. Alright, this turn I'm going to have to start looking at some budget saving because we are chewing through this budget. Sweden wants another one. No, Sweden, I'm building you two already. Calm down, mate. Alright, in 2 months these torpedo boats will be done. These will be commissioned. I think that'll help with the budget a little bit. I can't see us having to lower any of this yet. I definitely don't want to lower this. So it'd be to the transport capacity that'll go. No, Sweden. Or is that Venezuela? I don't know. But no. Other way, no. Okay, in a month, all of those will be done. In 5 months, ours will be done. We're not going to last that long. If anything, I don't really need it. So if worse comes to worse, I'll just suspend my own battleship. No, we must have finished building those light cruisers. Suddenly got that big influx of money. I knew I had the math down, right? Who doubted me? Who doubted me? If I get some naval prestige events, I'd poke the Austrians again. Although the Italians are poking me. So maybe I don't have to be so proactive with my poking the bear. We're so close to a war. I'm not trying to improve relations with France. We're disrespected. That's fine. They don't know who they're disrespecting. I don't know. Maybe they're laughing at themselves like, hom hom hom, those 50 Americans, they can win the war without us. The French. If you didn't know, France is basically the only reason the Americans won the War of Independence in 1776. And don't let them tell you otherwise, because they're lying. In fact, they helped so much, they bankrupted themselves, and it led to the French Revolution. So many men named Louis want to have a word with the Americans, I imagine. Right, so the balance bunches, the balance? Yeah, the budget has balanced itself. Looking at some small guns, Mark II 4 inches, that's great. More accurate mine sweeping wires. Looks like someone's gonna have to rebuild all of their light cruisers to do that. We probably should have anyway. I imagine if we do go to war with these guys, the mine sweeping is gonna be pretty intense, and no one wants me to have any naval prestige at all. Okay, mine sweeping wires are done. What that means for us is these old light cruisers are going to have to be refit. And I'm going to refit them as minesweepers. Ah, it's not going to let me. Interesting. I wonder if it's a problem with the hull. Let me hit into the refit mode. Mine lane, yes. Maybe it's not equipment. Maybe it's just a passive upgrade. Well, while we're in here, is there anything I do want to do? Okay. Can I bump that up? Yes. Speed. I don't really want to touch. I want to give them a range finder, and I want to let them mine, lay mines. And that's probably going to be it. Right, that's going to be it. It's a refit time of 1 month. It'll be fine. It will be fine. It's not going to help us tactically, but strategically, it's going to be huge. The more ships we have laying mines, we're shaping the battlefield. We're shaping the area of operation. We are denying the enemy action, and we are slowing down their, I can't remember what they call it. It's like it's your thought loop. It's your time it takes to take in information to make decisions. The more variables you add into that for an enemy commander, obviously reversing the AI, reversing a computer, it makes it a little bit harder. But the more variables you can introduce into their thought loop, their command loop, the longer it's going to take them to make decisions. And that's all warfare, essentially. I may have it written down here, or I may not. I'm going to spend too long looking. Yeah, it's building, and this is a phrase I really love: cost imposition. Mines build cost imposition. What does that mean? Essentially, when one nation is looking to attack another nation, they do math. They say, all right, what will I lose in this attack? What do I stand to lose? What do I stand to gain? And that's what they weigh up against each other. It's a win-loss like calculation. And the more variables you consider and the negative, such as mines, torpedoes, asymmetrical warfare, the higher those losses come, the more they have to try and win to balance that out. They might go to war with us for Mallorca, like Majorca, the Balearic Islands. If they're like, okay, we might lose 5 ships. If we can start laying out minefields and we can start flooding this area with torpedo boats, submarines, whatever, really making it a nightmare of asymmetrical warfare to punch through it, they might lose 20 ships. Suddenly, losing 20 ships for the Balearic Islands for this 62 million, 67 million, sorry, it's not worth it. And that's kind of what I'm aiming to do. Shape, deter, respond. How are we going to respond? Torpedo boats and battleships. Battleship, mind. And this is the basic principles of a smaller power fighting a larger power. I would say we're a near peer power to Austria. We're not a peer for certain. Just look at our GDP for a start. You can see their GDP is double ours, almost double ours. We're not a peer adversary. We're near peer. And a near peer power, you've got to think of things asymmetrically. How can we make this our lake? You know, the Romans had Mare Nostrum, the Roman lake. Well, I want this to be Mare Espanol. I want them to fear coming into the Western Mediterranean, and eventually the Central and Eastern as well, but we're not quite there yet. I would like to eat Portugal. Portugal's got a lot of money. I would like it to be my money. I don't think it's going to happen. If they could be allies, that'd be great. But yeah, I don't think it's going to happen. Research hasn't really changed. I'm not worried about most of this. Secondary turrets on light cruisers, that could be good. Control station, boilers would be great. The more funnel capacity, the better. In fact, I'm not building anything for a little while. Not while I'm so in debt building these battleships. Maybe once my battleship is built, I'll think about it. Probably build some more heavy cruisers. Just given that kind of our battleships, and it lets me start to retire some of those old, terrible, terrible heavy cruisers we have. Because right now, they're just, as I said during our last war, they're just donating victory points to the enemy. And I mean, hopefully now that there's 10 of them in one fleet, it'd be fine, but I don't really want to do that. In fact, if I could send 5 of them down to Valencia, that'd be great. 2, 3, 4. And they're just going to meet up with those torpedo boats there. And it just keeps the just keeps everything down here. See, I believe if we hover over that, they already have minesweeping. No, they have none. So it has to be an upgrade. Maybe it's an upgrade for torpedo boats. I'm not sure. Get a new light cruiser design. That's interesting. Bigger torpedo boats too. Not that we really need that. Ooh. Yes, I don't want to be bankrupt. Okay. What that means is we suspend the battleship. We suspend it until these are built. And we're probably going to drop down. This again. That'll change after these guys dock. They do dock, which they do. Got new ammo type. Okay. I can't suspend a ship I'm building for someone else. I gotta put these guys in limited. We'll be fine once these are built. It's just getting to that point. And we'll put the whole fleet in limited. We're not going to war anytime soon. Austria doesn't seem to be wanting to push buttons. I think we'll be fine. How do they think I'm going to pay for that again? I would love to do this for GDP, but I don't have that money. Minus license with France, we don't want to do that. I'll just take the unrest. So we're making money again. We're limited. What's that, 2 million? Can I resume building this guy? No. No, I cannot. That's okay. He's gonna come out so far behind, so out of date, it's not even funny. But it's honestly fine. It really doesn't matter. He's just a figurehead anyway. If he even sees battle, I call it a he. It's almost like the Bismarck thing. It's a she. Ships are always she. And don't let anyone tell you otherwise. The only man that didn't that ever said otherwise was a Hitler. So just take that into account. Ships are always a she. And if you ever serve on a ship or serve with ships, you'll know that to be true. There's an energy that radiates off them. Unrest with relations done. No, Sweden, no. Who are you trying to fight? Is Denmark giving them a hard time? I don't know, but they've decided they need more battleships. They have more battleships than me. Hey, right, well, since that's all sorted, we now have a budget. Thank you, event. We're going to resume building those. And is there anything I'm going to want to hold out for? Okay, boilers. Yeah, I'm gonna hold out for boilers. Then I'm gonna build this heavy cruiser. Because we have money again. In fact, to help, I'm gonna get rid of one of these old heavy cruisers. Right there. Where's this one? 1888. What's the dearest? Because I know they have a ton of impact their usage, their maintenance every month. So we're going to scrap the most expensive one. And we're going to build a new heavy cruiser. All right, Armored Cruiser 1. We're not going to want a hybrid light cruiser. Or do we? You know what? Actually, I think we do want a hybrid light cruiser. Standard. How big can we go? 4100. We'll do that. Speed 16 knots. We're going to aim for that. We go induced spoilers. Steam expansion engines. It's going to be expensive. But you can't really help that. In fact, we can not do those induced spoilers. We can go natural, which saves us a ton of money. Look at that. Yeah. Natural boilers will save us some money. No bar bets yet. Do we have any Mark II guns? We have Mark II 9-inch. Well, that's what we're going to be putting on here. Secondary guns, some Mark II 4-inch. Can't really put it anywhere. That's fine. We'll go case mode. Holy bloody hell, that's a lot. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of these front and back ones. We don't need them. What I do want is these. God, look at how much that nickel steel armor saves us. I'm not going to want 15-inch torps. They're just there to let people know not to stuff up. Got that. Hydraulic. We're going to want gun cotton. White powder. What does that do to our flash fire chance? It's actually not that bad. Armor. This is where it's going to be interesting. All right. 2 inches on the deck. Oh, I'm not going to get 2 inches on the deck. I'm going to want whatever our main belt can take. Plus some citadel. You know what? No shells are going to be coming down on the deck. It's too early in the... I usually like to future-proof my warships a little bit, but not at the expense of our main belt. That just doesn't sound like a smart idea. Okay. $17 million. That's going to cost us. For the San Juan de Gregorio. I apologize. I will continue to apologize. How much is the original? It's actually not that much more than our original. It's got smaller but better guns. It's got many more 4-inch guns. And it's got just as many. Okay, this is a good ship. Build time 10 months. What's the build time on this thing? 10 months. For a far better ship, yeah. We're doing well. What's the speed on this thing? It's even quicker. Yeah, this is perfect. This is an ideal heavy cruiser, I think. And I think it's a bit ahead of its time, too. So we're going to be pumping these out, if we can. If I have to, and I probably will scrap 4 or 5 of the old cruisers and build 4 or 5 of these. Just to make room. What's finances doing? We have 3 million. If I scrap 5 of these, how many do we have then? 4.9 million. Okay. I'm now going to build 5 of these. It's going to cost us 8 million a turn. We have a lot of naval funds. Why do we have so many naval funds? I'm assuming I agreed to something at some point. Well, that changes it. I'm building more. I'm building more. Simply because we can. Battleship finished building. That would be it. All right, well, where are we missing heavy cruisers? Okay, I want four in Valencia. And the rest will go to Barcelona. I think this makes me happy. This gives me warm and fuzzies. It immediately makes these obsolete, but that's fine. That is fine. They're that good, I don't mind. I mean, those tier 2 9-inchers are just a godsend. They really are going to make that so much better. Semi-dreadnought. Looks like we get new battleships too, which makes me really happy. I only built one of these. And it's immediately going to obsolete this thing, but that's fine. That's what it gets. I don't know what it did to get that, but that's what it gets. Probably going to want a bigger shipyard for doing that. But we've got to go to war for that. Because wars pay for shipyard expansions. Austria-Hungarians are provoking us. Interesting. Oh, we don't like each other. I'm going to try and increase relations with France because I don't want to be fighting two wars at once. We got an okay fleet. Our fleet's not that good. It's the armor on these things. It's the only thing that worries me. It's not as thick as I would like, but it's a good quality for this time period. Not good quality in general, but for this time period. But I bet anti-flash too. That'd be good. This battleship's going to be built and immediately refit. I can just see it already. You want light cruisers? You're going to pay a lot for them. Yes, Sweden. You may have them. France failed. Okay. They don't like us, which is fair. It's a big fleet. That's a scary fleet. They have a scary fleet. Very balanced. Eventually, if we get big enough, I'd like to take on the British. Whatever you call it, like building program, where they'd build two battleships every single year, just to keep on top of things. But I think that's going to be a little way away, little ways away. Hey, 2 months till we get hull strengthening. What's the special machinery? Hydraulic steering gear. Is it going to do anything for us? Turn rate, shift speed. Yeah. Naval warfare, naval bombardment. Mines, more mines, more mines. We like mines. We have many ships that like mines. God, we got a lot of torpedo boats. That's bad. That this is beautiful. You better once these are built. It's beautiful. As a battleship, they want to build another one. No, Sweden. No, they're gonna get frustrated soon. Like, oh, we want as a battleship. Why won't you build as a battleship? You can't have the battleship, Sweden. Don't need it. You don't need it. Flat out. Facts is facts. I want to see if I can refit this thing already. I know it's just been built, but we did have to suspend it a little bit. And I'm sure we have built something better since then. Some anti-torp. Yeah, it's worth it just for that, honestly. families are badly placed, but they have really good lines of fire. A Mark 1 11 inches. I don't think we have anything better than that. Right, just the 9 inches. Yeah, Mark 2 4 inches. They don't really fit anywhere. Which is fine. Alright, what about the 2 inches? Yeah, these things are just not set up. I was about to say to repel boarders in, but just to stop anyone from getting in close. Well, that's gonna have to do it. We got some 3 inches, we got some 4 inches. The ship is overweight. Well, that's fine. The ship doesn't need that much deck armor. That's fine. I'd rather have more of the guns than the anti-tall. Okay, we're going to save this, and we're going to immediately put it into refit. Because a battleship with an anti-tall is just... You're just asking to die, really. All right, how much is this going to cost us? 9 million. Okay, that's fine. It needs it. It really does need it, so that's fine. Next month we'll get our Dreadnoughts. I would like some better main guns. I wonder if I can rush that. And we're paying for all this research. Because the hull's nice. We don't really have enough size to make anything scary, I suppose. We can make something okay. But what I would like is just better big guns. I guess a Mark II 10 inch, that'd probably do me. New heavy cruiser, we just got new heavy cruisers. What do they want here? Mark II 5 inches, eh. Nothing else here really interests me. So I'll see you next time what it's going to give me. That's a lot of funds. I will take the naval prestige, just because I don't want to bump up that unrest. Research, this one. Big guns, 1 month. Mark II 10-inch guns. Okay, we've got a new Dreadnought hull, we've got new main guns, so we're building a new battleship. Which won't be able to afford for a while. But we have that much in the bank, it will be fun. I want to build some heavy cruisers. Sweden? No. No, I'm building my own thing. Make sure we turn off that focus. Are we in trouble? What do they want here? Advanced hydraulic turrets. Do I want to wait for that? If I prioritize it, it's 1 month. Yeah, I think that's worth waiting for. We'll wait for that. Yeah, I've built up a bit of naval prestige. I might try and poke the Austrians again. Yeah, let's go poke the Austrians. See what they do. I've got a lot of cruisers, but that's fine. I'm gonna poke the bear. We're going to poke the bear, and then we're going to build a battleship. Let's just say that the first battleship, our Radon Francisco de Assis, was to just get our shipyards into what it takes to build a battleship. Kind of like it's a your initial build, essentially. Your first in class. This is how you build a battleship. Oh, I need an upgrade. It needs 13,500. Bugger. I should check that. Yeah, now that our shipyards have built one, it's going to be incredibly expensive, incredibly inefficient as it was. And now they've built in their techniques, they've hired the right manpower, they're sitting there waiting for something better. Which is something you'll see in military procurement all the time. There's always that first in class. A lot of the time, the Yanks especially will attribute a lot of the teething money problems to the initial first in class, which is why you'll see the first one will be $5-7 million more expensive than all the rest of the ships. It's just because it's not, you can't put everything that's required to build a warship on the plans. Something's going to come up. Something's going to happen. And they plan for that. Not always. There's always scope creep. There's always trade unions getting involved. There's a lot of things that can blow out the budget. There's R&D not meeting it. There's untested technologies. There's domestic designs. Yeah, there's a million ways you can blow out the budget on a brand new warship. But there's also ways to mitigate it. And I'm going to say that's what we did. We built one. We tested the slipways. We're all well and good. Now we just need... we need bigger. It's going to take us 8 months. It's going to cost us $49 million. That's fine. But we're going to have enough to build a small battleship, which is what we need. Hey, 8 months, it's going to cost us an arm and a leg, but that's fine. We're going to be able to build a battleship at the end of it. Which just gives us 9 months to get cooler guns, honestly. armor quality. Can we rush that? Nothing else is really interesting right now. Let's see if we can rush armor quality and control stations. Let's rush these two. I want better range. I want more accuracy and I want better armor. The Italians want money. Or what? Or what? Swedes are still trying to build battleships? No, Sweden. No. Please stop. Right, where does that leave us politically? Ooh, that's juicy. That's going to come soon. Maybe not this episode, but it's going to come soon. We're preparing for it. We are preparing for it. Oh, we can even go a little bit bigger. 14,000 tons. We don't need something big. Just a pocket battleship. Just something to sit on the line and tank shots and force their battleships to shoot at while our torpedo boats sneak in. You can always say this is like a Frederick Mahan high-low, but it's not really. Because it's more like a battle fleet on a budget. It's just cost to position platforms and attrition reduction platforms. That's all it is. That's what we're building. Our CAs are going to be attrition reduction platforms. It's going to sit around, kind of guard convoys a little bit. They're going to be scary enough that a torpedo is not going to want to tangle with them. While our torpedo boats and our battleships, they're going to be attrition application. They're going to be cost imposition. And our CLs, mine laying. Mine laying and eventually mine sweeping, hopefully. Right, we'll click that intern button again. Interesting. What did the Soviet Union want? Alright team, this is almost the end of this episode. I'm sorry it's been a bit uneventful. I really wanted to get that battleship designed, but unfortunately, this sank that effort. Because you don't want to build something that's... We have a new hull. I want to use it. I want to use it well. We did refit our original. We built some more torpedo boats, more CLs. We're doing well. That's beautiful. All this is beautiful. It's going well. We might drag it out a little bit longer. Now we'll end it there. All right, guys. Have a great day. Thank you for watching and listening. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you next time. Thank you very much.